Anglo-American's Dawson Mine lies in the coal-rich country of central Queensland, Australia. To improve the site's fleet uptime, Cat dealer Hastings-Deering employs a condition monitoring program that has been enabled by Cat Equipment Care Advisor, a web-based dealer tool that combines equipment and application data with real-time analytics, plus the combined expertise of our Cat Global Dealer Network.
Dawson is a very busy site. It's got a very tough environment. We see a lot going on at Dawson. There's a lot of events. There's a lot of samples. The trucks are serviced every 10 days. Before condition monitoring came along, it was all a bit of reaction maintenance. So the machine actually had to break down before we'd get ready to perform a repair.
It was up to someone from site to filter through all that work, and very time consuming and expensive.
Data's always been there, but it's been in all different areas, and we've never been able before to bring it all together and get some meaning out of it.
ECA came into the site around about 2 years ago. In the beginning, it was a big learning curve for us in the way that we were doing condition monitoring to what ECA brings to the table. It's a different style of condition monitoring and how to customise it for our fleet. And we've been able to do that fairly successfully. So in that respect, it's great.
Equipment Care Advisor is a tool that we use that gathers data from five different sources, for example, oil samples, VIMS data, site inspections, and repair history, and compiles it into one database where we can easily compare all those elements of data and write an intelligent recommendation to the service department at a customer site.
Equipment Care Advisor is analysis of the machine's health. It's pretty comprehensive. There's a lot of data that comes from the machines that someone needs to interpret it and turn it into tasks that our fitters can go out and repair on the machine.
Some of the biggest hurdles we had in introducing ECA or Equipment Care Advisor to our customer sites was a culture change. Some of the older guys on site were familiar with doing condition monitoring their own way, which was a lot of reaction. Now with Equipment Care Advisor and using all the data, we've been able to present that to site, and when they actually see that data and they see the repair and how effective it was started getting some trust.
It is unbelievable the amount of information that you can actually look at that we never used to be able to see before.
So we're definitely seeing the benefit of how accurate, I suppose, the details are that's getting delivered. And we can capture faults and things before they get worse and escalate. It helps with our scheduling and planning, and then at the end of the day, the availability of the truck. So everyone's happy.
We can actually predict that if we've got a pump failure, or if we've got an accumulator failure, or gas is releasing out of the accumulator, we can pick all those things up from how the trends are that come through from ECA. And it's clever enough to tell us whether we've got an electrical fault or a mechanical fault.
There has probably been several times where we've pulled trucks up and checked them and found imminent failure, so we've been able to capture that before it happens.
Recently we've had an engine in one of our 797V machines giving us some pretty sketchy oil results. That's when we can bring in the electronic data and we can have a look at turbo boost pressures and oil pressure and tie all that in with the oil sample results, blow-by results, the VIMS data and the filter restrictions. And then we can ring up site and get them to do some tests at a service. Then we can write a definitive recommendation to site and say, you've got a broken piston ring in this engine, you need to schedule in a repair before it breaks down out in the field or gets any worse. So just before, we'd have to wait until the truck started blowing blue smoke.
Just a few weeks ago, we had an engine in distress. It was indicating it had upper cylinder wear. So that recommendation comes through from our analysts. Then we brought the truck in as soon as possible at its next stoppage and did some analysis and found that it actually did have one cylinder that was in distress. Replaced it, sent it back to work, and get a little bit more life out of that engine. Normally that would just run to destruction, and that's certainly not what we want, unscheduled stoppages.
Potential saving between bringing an engine in that we think is having a failure to it failing can be a saving of around $100,000. So if we can bring a truck in that we think is having a bearing failure that potentially is going to give us a failed crankshaft, ventilator block, broken conrod, so on and so forth, we can get it in, actually diagnose and say, yes, we're going to have an engine failure occurring. You've saved the block, you've saved the crank, you've saved conrods, pistons, so on and so forth. Massive saving.
Everyone's happy then too, because the repair is minor compared to a major. If anything has a catastrophic in the pit and stops mining operations, well, no one's happy then.
And that's a big thing that the customers notice now, is we haven't had many significant breakdowns. There's not as many surprises for them.
I think it always comes back to the relationship that we have with the customer. We had a very good relationship, it's very transparent, which is probably pretty unique, I think.
The customer feels quite at ease with us using the system. I'm extremely proud of the fact that we can meet our customers' expectations on reliability and availability, and we can continue to do it 365 days a year, 24 hours a day. So it's always proud to work for Caterpillar.